You know, no one ever mentions Jamaica when it comes to natural history. I know that it really didn't start getting good until the Eocene and Miocene, so like, no dinos, but still, the damn thing has been around for quite some time. Ancient Jamaica was a truly bizarre place. Before humans got there and wreaked havoc, there were so many cool things. The four-limbed ancestors of today's manatees, mini hornless tapir relatives, a crocodile that decided to become a gharial, a monkey, and a giant bird of prey that was just a bit too kicky. Among the menagerie of island weirdos was an ibis. This wasn't your ordinary bin chicken or tip turkey, nor the average long-billed ruby-hued birds you see at the zoo. These guys packed a punch, literally. The story begins all the way back in 1919 when American Museum of Natural History scientist Harold Anthony took an expedition to Jamaica to get a better understanding of its biology and paleontology. During his journeys, he found a bunch of old, gross pseudo-fossil bones lying around in a couple of caves. Here's the deal. Jamaica was birthed through a process somewhat similar to islands like Hawaii. The Caribbean region saw a slab of continent slip under another. This squashed out lava, which cooled, hardened, and formed the base upon which limestone would form to create the island of Jamaica. By the time the limestone stuff got going, it was already the Eocene epoch, so no Mesozoic critters ever lived on Jamaica to leave any fossils behind. Instead, some more geologic activity post-island creation jacked up Jamaica well above sea level to where it is today, and has been since, like, the Miocene or something. There are a bunch of caves in Jamaica because the only rock you got there is that gross, cruddy volcanic stuff on the bottom and the fossil-rich limestone scum on top of that. Turns out, limestone is super degradable. Anything acidic eats it up like nothing. Naturally, that means any even remotely acidic water ate away a bunch of holes and caverns through the limestone to make those caves, and animals were more than happy to take a load off in there. Bats that managed to fly there decided to stay there, and the caves gave them a good place to sleep. The caves preserve just about anything that decided to walk in there and die because they're essentially freeze-dried time capsules. In one of those capsules, the Longmile Cave, were the remains of a super bizarre form of ibis. These classic birds are known far and wide for their long, downturned pincer beaks, turkey necks, stork legs, and fancy colors and patterns. Harold Anthony had recovered a couple humeri, some toe bones, some foot bones, and some shoulder bones of this ibis, and brought them back to the museum. They stayed there till the 1970s, when a couple scientists found them to be weird enough to dedicate some time to describe and name. They called the bones Xenocybus zimpithicus, weird ibis who befriends monkeys. Well, the species name actually means with monkey because it was found with the remains of the now extinct Jamaican monkey, and probably lived with it. The Jamaican ibis was immediately considered weird back in the 70s because its bones suggest a flightless animal. This would make it the second extinct flightless ibis known, the other being from Hawaii. That's not a lot, but it's weird that it happened twice. By 2011, a bunch more specimens of the ibis were found and described. These fossils were far completer and reconstructed a bird that was a tad weirder than previously thought. The damn thing's hands were inflated, reinforced, and broad like mittens. They've been specifically compared to the club-like front limbs of the mantis shrimps, which used them to bludgeon their prey to death. It's unlikely these birds were doing that with their clubs, but exactly what they were doing remains mysterious. Some researchers have speculated that the Jamaican ibis used its wings as weapons. There are other species of living birds that use their wings as weapons too, but none have the flail or club-shaped hand and robust forearm. They just have some spikes or something. There were some predators these guys would have had to look out for, like the secretary bird-like Jamaican caracara. This bird of prey was a member of the falcon family and looked like its modern cousin, but with longer legs. A large boa, that Jamaican monkey, and a bunch of other birds of prey would have also made life difficult for the flightless birds, as well as their eggs and young. These would have been the nastiest thing Xenocybus needed to use its clubs against. Another explanation for the wings was pummeling. Perhaps they used their wings in boxing matches against one another as a sexual display to fight for the attention of the ladies. I'd like to know what kind of force would have been behind those clubs. Imagine getting walloped by a bird. Not kicked, not disemboweled, not pecked, but literally punched in the face. The arm bones of these birds show traumatic injuries, which would have only been sustained if they were used as weapons. Some have fractures, others have fracture calluses, meaning the bone healed after it was broken. The Jamaican ibis isn't the largest known ibis, but it was still a large one at about 2 kilograms or 4 pounds. Since ibises are medium-sized birds, they didn't really get the dwarfism or gigantism you see in some island fauna. Dwarfism occurs when larger animals move to small islands with little resources. Gigantism occurs when small animals land on big islands with lots of resources. That's grossly oversimplified, but I think it gets the point across. No embiggening and no shrinking. But these ibises did become flightless, which is something that happens relatively frequently to island-dwelling birds. So, what killed them? I'd like to say humans or human-caused problems, but there's just too little information about it. The monkey remains found with the ibis bones were found in the lowest layer of the caves, which were made of limestone. The caves also had a pile of leftover detritus from the island's indigenous inhabitants, who only got to the island like 4,000 years ago BC. The exact age of the ibis bones is unknown, since the guy who first found them didn't say where he found them. Exactly when these birds went extinct is a bit mysterious. They may have been there when people got there, but they may have gone bye-bye naturally, so guess we'll have to just wait and see. For more interesting stories about nature, the history of life, or what goes bump in the night, subscribe, hit the bell icon for updates, like this video, and drop a comment in the comment section below. Thanks for watching. Special thanks to my elephant tier patrons, Thea Svensson, Staniforth Hopkins, Dinosaur, and Arda Bayer, as well as my Tyrannosaurus tier patrons, Henry Brennan, Danny Van Heck, Dana Manchester, Chris Frampton, and Admin.